Hi. It's just I'm continuing from here. However, we who come from Africa, this is not new to us because this is how life is out there. We deal with the black witchcraft. And so fetish priests, these are priests who consult the demons and try to help people using demonic spirits and then inflict them later on with different worse situations. Then we have spiritual churches where angels are worshipped. We have some people who go to white garment churches. And these white garment churches, they worship angels, fallen angels. And it's funny that the devil is deceptive to the extent that they worship things, angels, fallen angels, with names like the real ones like Michael, Gabriel. No, these are all evil, demonic, occultic churches. So spiritual churches where angels are worshipped. Fortune tellers, I've talked about it. Joining the Freemason society, committing adultery or fornication. But sometimes when you go and commit fornication or adultery with an unbeliever, you never know the person who he is. If he's into a cult, they transfer those spirits into you. Reading demonic books. There are some books which are demonic. By the time you finish reading it, the demons have entrance into your life. Watching pornographic materials, you are introducing yourself to the demon of lust, fornication, and adultery. We have people who drink holy water. They call something like holy water. There's nothing like holy water. It is demonic water. It has demonic influences. They promise that if you drink it, it will heal you. If you drink it, it will protect you. These are all false. It leads people. It opens you up for demonic spirit. Joining a cult group, burning of incense and candles to invite spirit. There are some people who burn incense and candles. No, churches like the Buddhist religion, like Buddha, Buddhist, and some of these cultic things. They are all inviting demonic spirit. Involving oneself in some evil traditional practices. There are some traditions which are solely satanic, even though they are cultural, traditional practices, but they are not biblical. Whenever you partake of it, you are worshiping an idol, you are worshiping a demon, and the demon will have influence in your life. Transcendental meditation, people who practice yoga, palm reading, and magic, they are all demonic gateways into our lives. So now, by now, you know if you have compromised yourself in any way, in any form, to allow these demons to have entrance. I would like to also define one or two terms which will help you to better understand this self-deliverance. When we talk about familiar spirits are simply demons who float around. You know, when Satan was cast down, he came not only by himself, but with one third of the fallen angels. And these angels are what are demanding worship from man, because Satan promised them that if they would deny their allegiance to God and their loyalty to God and follow him, he promised that when he takes over, he's going to give them a powerful position. So this, most of the angels, one third of them, rejected God, followed Satan, and so now they are demanding worship. They are demanding worship. So some of the demons, we have demons in hierarchies. We have different levels in the demonic realms. Some of them are just on this, are ground troops. The same way we have marine, we have the ground troops, and we have those who are air force. In the demonic realms, we have the air force, we have the ground troops, and we have demons that lives in the ocean. You know, but we have these ground troops, demons who are floating around. Some of them are called the familiar spirit. They usually follow people and really monitor your life and are able to gather data, information about you. So what happens is that when you go to a witch and you or a sorcery or a psychic, and the psychic is telling you something about yourself, what they are doing is that they are tapping into this, consulting these demonic familiar spirits to relay information about you to them a data about the things that they have gathered out after they've watched your life for a long time. So you, the psychic will tell you your name, where you come from, your mother's name, where you live. All these things are given to them by these demonic spirits, because they are always floating around watching us as we go up and down. So they're able to give data to these, and especially they're able to do that because most of these people who consult these psychic and sorcery and witchcraft, these are people who are not Christians. These are people who are, even if they are Christians, they are not serious. So the devil already is able to monitor their lives and be able to do come in and gather information about them. And so it is easy. It is easy. Remember that even in the book of Corinthians, I think 1 Samuel, about when Saul went to consult a medium to find information about Samuel, and was able to gather information. You know, these are very occultic things. God doesn't want us to meddle or dabble or touch or get into. And so what these familiar spirits does is that they give information to these witches or sorcery or psychic, and the psychics begin to tell you. And so when you hear about familiar spirit, these are demonic spirits relaying information to witches, psychic. So the psychic don't have power in themselves. They are tapping into this demonic spirit to gather information about you. But God doesn't want us to do that. When we read 1 Corinthians, let's read Deuteronomy chapter 7, verse 25 to 26. Deuteronomy chapter 7, 25 to 26, it says that the graven image of their gods shall ye burn with fire. Thou shalt not desire the silver or gold that is on them, nor take it unto thee, lest thou be snared therein. For it is an abomination to the Lord thy God. Neither shalt thou bring an abomination into thine house, lest thou be cursed, thou be a cursed thing like it. But thou shalt utterly detest it, and thou shalt utterly abhor it, for it is a cursed thing. God here was talking to Israel not to even bring anything which has been sacrificed to demons and bring it into your life, into your house. It is an accursed thing, and if you bring it into your house or into your life, you will become cursed by that thing. When we read 1 Corinthians chapter 10, 19 to 20, it says that, what says then I, that the idols is anything, or that which is offered to the... He says, what says I then, that the idols is anything, or that which is offered in a sacrifice to idol is anything? But I say that the thing which the Gentiles sacrifice, they sacrifice to the devil and not God, and would not that ye should have fellowship with evil. So some of the things this unbelievers sacrifice, they sacrifice to idols who are demons, and so God doesn't want us to have anything to do with it. When we have anything to do with it, it becomes an accursed thing, and we become influenced by them. When you read, so we have talked about familiar spirit and familiar object. Let me talk about familiar object. Familiar objects also are things which people go to the fetish priest, they go to these sorcerers, go to psychic and collect from them. When you bring these things from this occultic society or occultic group or religion, you bring it into your house, you allow those things have demons in it, and those things are able to get to know what is going on in your life and relay information to the enemy, to Satan, so that he can have access. So anything which is satanic, when you wear it on yourself like a talisman for protection or for healing or anything, you are just allowing familiar demons to also get attached to it, so that they can get access into your life. For the familiar spirits, the first one we read was familiar object. Let's read something about the familiar spirit. When we read Deuteronomy chapter 18, 10 to 11, it says that there shall not be found among you any that maketh his son or his daughter pass through the fire, or you said divination. Divination is not from God. Or observe times. Observation of times is no good. Astrology, enchanters, witchcraft, charmers, or consulters with familiar spirits. Here, God doesn't want us to deal with familiar spirits or familiar objects. They are all demonic, and we compromise ourselves to allow demons to enter into us. I want us to also look to some things like spells, incantation, hexes, and curses. Spells, incantation, hexes, and curses. When some people can go to a fetish priest and tell them to, you know, they want the fetish priest to curse you. And what it happens is that they summon a demon to perform a given action against you. Or calling upon a demon and then sending it to the to perform a certain influence or damage to you. So curses, hexes, divination, or spells are just witches or diviners or occultic people summoning demons to do a specific evil against you. But the thing is, if you're an unbeliever, you can be touched by these things. If you're a Christian and you're not serious, you can be touched by this. But I bet you, if you're a born-again believer, filled with the Holy Spirit, and you are living right, covered by the blood, they can never touch you. For greater is he who is within us than that which is outside. Some people also go to the fetish priest to receive amulets, talisman for protection, for healing, and all these things defile the temple of the living God. And it gives the devil the opportunity to come in, oppress you, suppress you, depress you, make your life miserable. And we have tattoo. Tattoo is a satanic thing, because anytime you are cut, it is a Babylonian religious thing, which is all occultic. People writing on their bodies, it is all satanic. People piercing their lips, their navels, and different parts of their body, they are giving room for the devil to enter in. If you have done any of these things, it is time for you to ask for forgiveness of sin, turn away from these things, and God will deliver you. So I hope that by now you know, if you have consulted any fetish priest, you have involved in anything that doesn't glorify God. Today, you just have to. The first level is confessing your sins to God, because you have sinned against him by doing something which is evil. And then the second level we will do is casting those demons out of your life, so that you can have your liberty and your freedom to be able to worship God. It is very important that you understand this, so that you perform self-deliverance. So first of all, we are going to pray and ask for forgiveness from God if peradventure we have touch or been involved in any of these things who doesn't glorify him, and ask that he forgives us. We are going to lead you into a prayer of repentance and a prayer for forgiveness. The reason why I'll be maybe repeating the prayer maybe one or two or three times is that you may understand. When I'm praying by myself, I don't repeat God, Heavenly Father, Heavenly, no, I don't do that. I only do that when I'm leading people in prayers, so that they get it. Because sometimes if you say it one, they don't even know what they say. I want to say it and say it again for you to understand what we are dealing with, and for you to also pray it out. A time will come when I'll tell you to look into your life and also diagnose that if there is anything that we've talked about which you have been involved, then immediately you have to be able to confess that thing. You have to confess that, Lord, I've sinned against you by getting involved in Ouija board, sorcery, witchcraft, control, hypnosis, medium, water witching, ESP, signs of zodiac, table tipping, levitation, clairvoyance, soul traveling, astral projection, necromancy, seance, handwriting analysis, fortune telling, voodoo magic, crystal balls, palm reading. Immediately, whatever thing you have done, tattooing, immediately mention that thing. Mention it and tell the Lord to forgive you. Mention the thing that you have done, which has opened the demons to come in to inhabit your body, or to oppress and suppress you, to deny you the joy of your salvation. If you are ready, before we even start, I want you to begin to meditate and tell God, tell the Holy Spirit to help you to remember the area you have sinned against God by the things you got involved in. I just want to give you a few seconds. Just look into your life. What is the thing that you have done, which you know you shouldn't have done? Have you consulted a fetish priest in the past to help you to become rich, to help you become pregnant, to help you, you know, overcome a problem? Have you got involved with voodoo, black magic, witchcraft, sorcery, spells, talisman? Do you have a talisman, amulet protecting you, or trying to bring good luck into your life? Have you brought in any object or book which is occultic, Hindu book, which is accursed, which you have brought into your house? If you have all these things, you have to remove it from your house. You have to burn it and remove it. Cast it away. That is those demons who continue to stay. Have you opened yourself up into watching pornographic materials? Have you allowed demons to enter you by the music you listen to, the movies you watch, the things you've been seeing, the friends that you work with who have allowed you to compromise your stand? Let God reveal it to you and be willing to forsake it. 2 Timothy chapter 2 verse 18 says that, "And the Lord will deliver me from every evil work and preserve me to his heavenly kingdom." The Lord will deliver me from every evil work. Everything that you have done in the past, if you are sincere with yourself, God will deliver you. Are you ready to be delivered? Here, Timothy says that the Lord will deliver me from every evil work. Whatever you have done in the past, God is willing to deliver you. But are you ready to be delivered? Or are you willing to still hold on to that demon? Are you still holding on to that books, that talisman, that item that you got from that occultic society? Are you ready? Okay, let's do it. Let's pray a prayer of forgiveness and repentance. So I may be repeating the prayers maybe two or three times to just make you repeat it after me. And please, at this point, just make sure you find yourself a place where you can do this. It's very important. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, Heavenly Father, Creator of the heavens and the earth, Creator of the heavens and the earth, you are the great and awesome God. You are the great and awesome God who keeps his covenant, who keeps his covenant and mercy with those who love and keep his commandment, who keeps his covenant and his mercy with those who love and keep his commandment. Heavenly Father, Heavenly Father, I have sinned against you. I have sinned against you and committed iniquity and have done wickedly and rebelled, even departed from your precept and your commandment. Heavenly Father, I have sinned and committed iniquity. I have sinned and committed iniquity and have done wickedly and rebelled, even departed from your precept and your commandment by getting myself involved with, put in the blank. What have you gotten yourself involved in? Have you gotten yourself in witchcraft? Just say it right now. Heavenly Father, I have sinned and committed iniquity. I have done wickedly and rebelled, even departed from your precept and your commandment by getting myself involved in sorcery, witchcraft, clairvoyance, sorcery, occultic freemen's sin society. Anything that you have done, just mention it. Let's move on. I have, out of ignorance, let's continue. I have out of ignorance and willful disobedience and out of curiosity defiled my body. I have out of ignorance, willful disobedience and curiosity defiled my body, which is the temple of the Holy Spirit, by coming into contact with unclean thing and unclean demons. Unclean things and unclean demons. What is the unclean thing that you have come into contact with? And what is the demonic things that you have got involved in? Mention it. That, Lord, I have out of ignorance or willful disobedience and out of curiosity defiled my body, which is the temple of the Holy Spirit, by coming into contact with the unclean things and demons. mention that thing. The next one is, I acknowledge that I have sinned against you by defiling the temple, by defiling my body, which is the temple of the Holy Spirit. I acknowledge and I have sinned against you by defiling the temple, which is the body, which my body, which is the temple of the Holy Spirit, by getting myself involved in mentioning the thing that you have gotten yourself involved in. The second is, I repent of my sins. I repent of my sins and ask for your forgiveness. I repent of my sins and ask for your forgiveness. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, by the power of the Holy Spirit, I ask that you create in me a clean heart. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, by the power of the Holy Spirit, I ask that you create in me a clean heart. Wash me and clean me with the precious blood of Jesus Christ. Wash me, cleanse me, and with the precious blood of Jesus Christ. Deliver me completely from the influence of demonic forces. Deliver me completely from the influence of demonic forces and fill me afresh with the Holy Spirit. And fill me afresh with the Holy Spirit. The last one is, restore unto me the joy of your salvation. Restore unto me the joy of your salvation and renewed arise spirit in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 This should be your prayer. This should be your prayer. This should be your prayer that the Lord himself should forgive you. I'm going to go over the prayer one more time and I want to make sure that you get it. Heavenly Father, creator of the heavens and earth. Heavenly Father, creator of the heavens and earth. You are the creator. You are a great and awesome God. You are a great and awesome God who keeps his covenant and his mercy to those who love and keep your commandment. Heavenly Father, I have sinned and committed iniquity and have done wickedly and rebelled, even departing from your precept and your commandment by getting myself involved in, that you mentioned it. I have, out of ignorance or willful disobedience and curiosity, defiled my body, which is the temple of the Holy Spirit, by coming into contact with unclean things and demons. The next, I acknowledge that I have sinned against you by defiling my body, which is the temple of the Holy Spirit, by getting myself involved in mentioning the thing that you have done to defile your body. I repent of my sins and I ask for your forgiveness. I repent of my sins and ask for your forgiveness. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, by the power of the Holy Spirit, I ask that you create in me a clean heart. Create in me a clean heart. Wash me and clean me with the precious blood of Jesus Christ. Wash me and cleanse me with the precious blood of Jesus Christ. Deliver me completely from the influence of demonic forces and fill me afresh with the Holy Spirit. Restore unto me the joy of your salvation and renew and arise spirit within me in Jesus' name. That is you asking forgiveness from your Heavenly Father. You asking forgiveness from your Heavenly Father. If you have done that, it means that you are now at peace with your Heavenly Father. Now we are going to enter into the next level. The next level is whereby what is called denouncing and renouncing your involvement in the occultic realms. You are renouncing and you are denouncing the vows and the oaths and the things that you got yourself involved in. Right now, you have asked God to forgive you because you went to do the accursed things. The Lord has forgiven you. Believe it, God has forgiven you if you have truly repented and asked in out of sincerity. The next level is now you are going to, in the name of Jesus Christ, by the power of the Holy Spirit, command those demons to come out of your body. You are going to drive out those demons out of your life, even in the name of Jesus Christ. You are going to tell them to lose their legal hold over your life. And you do that by, we have two terms, two definitions you have to understand before you do this. We have what is called, when we talk about, you have to revoke, you have to renounce and you have to revoke your relationship with these things. The first one is renouncing. You have to renounce. You have to renounce the things that you did in the past. You have to renounce your involvement with the Ouija board. You renounce your involvement with sorcery. You have to renounce your involvement with witchcraft, control, hypnosis, medium, water witching, signs of zodiac, levitation, soul traveling, magic, voodoo, fortune telling, witchcraft, black magic, black witchcraft, white witchcraft, necromancy, science, crystal ball, palm reading. You have to renounce your involvement or your attendance to that fetish priest. You have to renounce it. You have to tell them you have no partnership with them. What is renouncing? Renouncing is to give up by formal declaration. You are formally telling them, or to put aside voluntarily our association with satanic network in Jesus' name. You have to declare it. You have to tell them openly that from today, I have no involvement with you anymore in the name of Jesus Christ. I renounce you. I have no partnership. I have no involvement. I have no association. I separate myself from you today. From this forth, I separate myself. That is declaring. Voluntarily, not by force. You have to voluntarily renounce your partnership with those demons, those fetish spirits, those occultic things. And you also have to revoke is to take back or withdraw or annul or cancel or reverse any covenant we made with any secret society in Jesus' name. So the first one is renouncing, declaring that we have no involvement with these spirits anymore, with these groups anymore, with these occultic things anymore. We have to renounce it, declare it openly. He says renouncing is to give up formally, formal declaration, or put aside voluntarily. You are putting aside any involvement or any association with any satanic network in the name of Jesus Christ. So we are going to renounce. You are going to break yourself loose from any involvement with any of the occultic or any of the accursed things that you got yourself involved some years back or recently, which has allowed the demons to have a legal hold. Because if you don't renounce them, if you don't tell them that you don't like them anymore, they will still be living inside you. They will still be oppressing you. They will still be suppressing you. They will still be depressing you. They will still be stealing the joy of your salvation. They will still deny you the presence of God, because they will still be in you. That demon of lust, that demon of masturbation, that demon of unforgiving, those demons that you have contracted by watching movies and listening to profane songs, or going to the internet to watch pornography, nude ladies, or going to the clubs to drink and look at nudie men, and gotten yourself with Ouija board, sorcery, witchcraft, hypnosis, medium, water witching, ESPs, signs of zodiac, psychic, handwriting analysis, magic, fortune telling, crystal balling, palm reading, books about demons, fetish priests, astral projection. You have to renounce them. So we are going to do that in the right now. Let's do it. In the name of Jesus Christ, in the name of Jesus Christ, by the power of the Holy Spirit, I right now renounce my involvement with any Ouija board mentioning that thing. I renounce my involvement with any sorcery. I renounce my involvement with any witchcraft. I renounce my involvement with any hypnosis. I renounce my involvement with any medium. I denounce my involvement with any Eastern religion, Hinduism, Muslim, Catholicism, Mormon, Confucianism, Krishna, Jehovah Witness, Scientology, metaphysics, Christian science, yoga, Freemason, tattoo, hexes, charm, celibacy. I renounce myself from all these occultic groups and occultic society in the name of Jesus Christ. Today, I disconnect myself from every partnership, from any demon. I denounce myself from any Mormon church, from any Catholic worship, from any worship of fetish priest and fetish demon. I renounce myself. I renounce any association. I break every soul tie. I break every partnership. I break any association. I break every communion, every fellowship I ever had with them. I renounce myself. I disconnect myself with the precious blood of Jesus Christ from their influence today. Today, I divorce myself. Today, I separate myself. Today, I disqualify myself from their groups, even in the name of Jesus Christ. I renounce them, that I have no dealings with them anymore. I have no dealings with the black magic. I have no dealings with the voodoo. I have no dealings with sorcery. I have no dealings with Ouija board. I have no dealing with hypnosis. I have no dealing with medium worship. I have no dealing with sorcery. I have no dealing with necromancy. I have no dealing with clairvoyance. I have no dealing with science. I have no dealing with astrology. I have no dealing with palm reading. I have no dealing with crystal balling. I have no dealing with breakdancing. I have no dealing with soul traveling. I have no dealing with any Mormon church. I have no dealing with any Confucianist. I have no dealing with Islamic church. I have no dealing with Scientology, Christian Science. I have no dealing with any tattoo and hexes. I have no dealing with any of these demonic forces. I have no dealing with any Lady Gaga music. I have no dealing. I disconnect myself. I disassociate myself from them today in the name of Jesus Christ. I cover myself and I relieve myself from them in the name of Jesus Christ. I use the blood of Jesus Christ to break every soul tie. I disconnect myself from every spirit of homosexuality. I disconnect myself from every spirit of unforgiveness. I disconnect myself from every demonic influence. I disconnect myself from every occultic group. In the name of Jesus Christ, in the name of Jesus Christ, I renounce myself from any involvement with any occultic and Eastern religion, and any yoga, and any meditation, any transcendental meditation, any table tapping, levitation. I renounce myself completely in Jesus' name. Renounce yourself. Tell them that in the name of Jesus Christ, by the power of the Holy Spirit, you renounce yourself. You disconnect yourself. You disassociate yourself. You divorce yourself from every partnership that you ever had with them. You disconnect yourself, even in Jesus' name, even in the name of Jesus Christ. Mention that sin. Mention that thing you did that God brought them in. Mention it and say, I renounce. I divorce myself. I today disconnect myself from you in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. I break every soul tie. I break every covenant. And I break every yoke in the name of Jesus Christ. After you've done this, the next level is to revoke. To revoke means that to take back, to withdraw, annul, to cancel, and reverse. Some of us, when we went into this fetish priest, this occultic witchcraft, we made our Freemason society, occultic religion, they make us make sacrifices and make an oath, make a covenant. And they say the day you break this covenant, you will die, or this will happen to you. Today, in the name of Jesus Christ, you can break that covenant. You can reverse that oath. You can disconnect yourself from that vow. And it cannot be used against you. You are going to reverse it. You are going to cancel it. You are going to annul it in the name of Jesus Christ, by the blood of Jesus Christ. So let's do it. In the name of Jesus Christ, in the name of Jesus Christ, by the power of the Holy Spirit, every oath, every covenant, anything that I said in agreement with any of these false religion and all demonic forces, today, I reverse it in the name of Jesus Christ. I reverse every ritual that I ever did. I annul it in the name of Jesus Christ. I cancel it in the name of Jesus Christ. I renounce it. I renounce it. I reverse it. I cancel it with the precious blood of Jesus Christ. May it never be used against me in the name of Jesus Christ. May every curse that was attached to it be turned into blessing. Because today, I repent and I reverse it. I repent and I cancel it in the name of Jesus Christ. I redeem myself with the precious blood of Jesus Christ. From today, you have no partnership with me anymore. Today, you have no partnership with me anymore. in the name of Jesus Christ. Now the third one is command those demons to leave you right now. In the name of Jesus Christ, in the name of Jesus Christ, by the power of the Holy Spirit, I command every demon of witchcraft to come out of my body, every demon of anger, every demon of unforgiveness, every demon of homosexuality, every demon of psychic, every demon of familiar spirits, every demon that is influencing my life, that is oppressing me, that is depressing me, that is repressing me, I command you out of my life. I destroy your influence over my life in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I command you out. I command you out. I command you out. I command you out. Every demon I've contracted out of watching pornographic movies, out of I've contracted out of listening to worldly songs, out of watching the horror movies, out of watching Harry Potter, I denounce you. I command you out of my life right now. I command my body, soul, and spirit to be delivered in the name of Jesus Christ. Every demonic influence over my life be broken by the power of the Holy Spirit. Be broken by the power of the Holy Spirit. Be broken by the power of the Holy Spirit. I disconnect myself right now in Jesus' name from the influence of every demonic spirit that has been released to taunt me, to oppress me, to suppress me, to make my life miserable. I deliver myself in Jesus' name. I deliver myself in Jesus' name. Mention that demon and cast them out. Every demon of homosexuality, every demon of masturbation, every demon of bitterness, every demon of anger, every demon of depression, every demon of fear, every demon that has got access because of witchcraft, every demon of yoga, every demon of levitation, every demon of sorcery, every demon of witchcraft, every demon of witchy board, every demon of water witching, every demon of voodoo, I cast you out of my body, astral projection, astrology, every demon having influence over my life because of my involvement with horoscope, I cast you out in Jesus' name, spiritualism, mediums, every demon who has come into my life, I cast you out. I command you in the name of Jesus Christ to walk out of my body now in Jesus' name. Out of my body, soul, and spirit. Out of my body, soul, and spirit. I break your hold. I break your influence over my life in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, I command you by the power of the Holy Ghost in Jesus' name to walk out of my body because now my body belongs to Jesus Christ. You cannot dwell in me. You cannot have influence upon me because I am a child of God. I've repented and I've turned back to my God. Go away and go come no more. Go away and come no more. Even in Jesus' name. Even in Jesus' name. James chapter 4 verse 7 says that resist the devil and he will flee from you. Resist the devil. We resist you, every demon. I resist you in Jesus' name to walk out of my body. I set my body, soul, and spirit free. I set my mind free. I set my eyes free. I set my soul free. Today, the joy of the Lord will be mine. Come out and go and come no more. In Jesus' name. The fourth level is that the Bible says that when we cast a demon out, we have to make sure we are not empty. And that they'll come out seven much stronger. They'll come back seven times stronger to habit you. We have to pray right now that your body, which is now emptied of these demonic influences, will be filled with the Holy Spirit. And I encourage you to read the Bible so that the Word of God will fill you. So that when they come, you'll be filled with the Word of God, with the Holy Spirit. They will not be able to oppress you, suppress you, depress you, and make your life miserable anymore. Because the Holy Spirit will begin to give you the joy of the Lord. Now let's pray for the Holy Spirit to fill this new temple, which you are now consecrated and dedicated to God. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I pray right now that you fill me. You fill me. You fill me with the Holy Spirit. Fill me with the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, come and fill me. Come and occupy this temple. Come and abide in me. Come and help me to live for you. Even in Jesus' name. Fill me, Holy Spirit. I live for you from now onwards. Have your way in my life in the name of Jesus Christ. From today, you have to begin to read the word. You have to begin to rely on the Holy Spirit. And you have to make sure that any source, anything that you have taken from occultic world, any product, any decorative program that you use to decorate your house, any book, anything, any charm, you have to burn them. You have to throw it out of your house. If you keep them, it will still give the demons access into your heart. you can't say you are delivered from homosexuality if you don't delete all the homosexual, all the nude and all the pornographic materials from your web page. You have to delete all association with the Hindu and yoga and everything. Disconnect yourself completely and begin to allow the Holy Spirit to lead you. May God bless you. If you have done this, I believe that God, this is the first stage of your own self personal deliverance. If you mean business with God, God will definitely deliver you, because he has said in 2 Timothy chapter 4 verse 18, and the Lord will deliver me from every works and every evil works and preserve me for the heavenly kingdom. God will deliver you. God will definitely deliver you. If you need extra help, at least you have done the first part. Before you go to your spiritual anybody to help you, you know what to expect. You know what to do. First, you have to repent and ask for forgiveness from God. Second, you have to renounce your association. You have to cast those demons out. You have to break those vows, reverse them, and you have to fill your temple with the Holy Spirit. And now, the joy of the Lord will be your strength. May God bless you. Shalom. Take care.